غرباء 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 غرباء.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على خير خلق الله أجمعين، وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على سبيله ونهجه إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا، أما بعد. Okay, so inshallah the program for this evening is that inshallah we're going to begin with our esteemed Sheikh, Sheikh Abdul Aziz Al-Sathan, Hafizahullah, and he's going to give us a short reminder around about half an hour concerning the topic that was advertised, concerning advice and the Salafi vision for the youth. And then inshallah after that we're going to take a short break, 10 to 15 minutes, and then we're going to move on to the final session of the day, which will be a conclusion of what we started last night. For those of you that were present yesterday, we had a very beautiful session with the Sheikh, where he allowed all of the brothers to pose questions to him concerning his journey on knowledge, concerning the experiences that he had with his teachers, concerning questions that you may have that you can gain benefit from our Sheikh. And there were, when we finished yesterday, there were still a lot of brothers who had a lot of questions. There were still a lot of brothers who had their hands raised and we couldn't get to them. And I could see that a lot of the brothers were disappointed and the Sheikh could see as well. But because the time was so late, we had to finish. But alhamdulillah, the Sheikh has agreed to continue that inshallah tonight, so that everyone has an opportunity or another opportunity to ask those questions. So again, as yesterday, as we had the etiquette that the brothers displayed, the beneficial questions that were posed to the Sheikh, inshallah, we hope that that will continue today as well. All of the questions for that session from the brothers must be verbal. Can't write stuff down. For brothers, you got to stand and you got to speak. If you want to ask the Sheikh a question, you have to stand and you have to speak. However, for the sisters, they can write their questions and send them forward. So no brothers writing in pink ink or anything like that, right? Brothers, stand and speak. Sisters can write and they can pass their questions forward. Any questions that you have or any questions that come, please don't place them on the stage. Don't come up in the middle of while the Sheikh speaking or I'm translating and come and put the questions on the stage or on the table. To my left, there's a brother standing there, inshallah, in this cordoned off area who will take your questions, inshallah. So with that, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we'll allow our Sheikh to begin. Falitafaddal mashkoor.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على رسول الله، أما بعد، فمعشر الفضلاء والفاضلات، أتحدث في هذا المجلس عن مرحلة الشباب، هذه المرحلة العمرية التي تعد من أخصب مراحل العمر، وكيف اهتم بها الإسلام وهذبها.
So the Shaykh, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations upon our Prophet and Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, my dear brothers and sisters, we're going to begin in today's lecture to speak about the issue of the youth and the age of youth. And this is a time or a stage in our life. It is a time where people go and undergo many changes, and there are many issues surrounding this part of our lives, the time of youth and the age of youth. So I want to speak about how Islam has paid extra care and attention to this age, the age of youth, and the different things that Islam has brought regarding it.
والإسلام اهتم بالإنسان في جميع أطوار حياته، بل اهتم بالإنسان قبل وجوده، فحث على اختيار الزوجة الصالحة.
The Sheikh continued and he said that Islam, it has paid attention to all of the stages of the development of a person, all of your phases of life, all of the different ages that you pass by. Islam has come and it has given guidance for all of these stages. Even before you were born, even the stage before you were born, Islam has come with guidance for this stage as well. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised us, and in our religion we have advice about choosing a suitable spouse, a suitable partner, so that the child when it is born will have a righteous upbringing.
واهتم الإسلام بالجنين في رحم أمه فرتب هناك أو على ذلك أحكام يراعى فيها الجنين وفيما يتعلق بخروجه من الرحم في اختيار الاسم الحسن وفي العقيقة وفي الحضانة والنفقة.
And the Shaykh said that Islam has come and it has given us rulings and guidance regarding the child when it's still in the womb of its mother. And likewise, Islam has come with guidance and it has educated us about what we should do when the child comes out into this world, when the mother gives birth to the child, how we give it a good name, how we let it taste something which is sweet, how we give the aqiqah for the child, and so on and so forth.
واهتم الإسلام بالإنسان في حال صغره في حال صباه فحث الوالدان على أمره بالصلاة مروا أولادكم بالصلاة لسبع وحث الوالدان على تقويم الولد بالخلق الطيب والأدب الفاضل.
And Islam has come with guidance and with principles and it has educated and taught us how we should pay attention to the young Muslims when they're at a very small age, our children, when they're at a very small age, when they're still little boys and girls, and how we should pay attention to them. And Islam has come and it has encouraged the parents that they should, for example, teach them how to pray at the age of 7. And it has come and told us that we should ensure that our children develop a good character.
وكما عني الإسلام بالإنسان في حال شبابه كما سيأتي الكلام بعد قليل فإن الإسلام أيضا عني بالمسلم في حال شيخوخته وشيبته.
And likewise, just as Islam has come with guidance and rulings for a person when they're in the stage of their youth, and this is something which we'll go on to in more detail in shortly, inshallah. Likewise, it has also spoken about old age and how we should also treat people who are in senior in age.
فأمر بتوقير كبير السن وأمر بأن يقدم في الكلام وأن يقدم عند الطعام والشراب وبين أن احترام المسن صاحب الشيبة قربة أو طاعة من الطاعات.
So Islam has come and it has told us that we must respect and honor our elders, that they are the ones who we should allow to speak first. They are the ones who we allow to eat first and to drink first. And Islam has come and it has taught us that to respect our elders and those people whose hair has grown white, it is from the acts of obedience in Islam.
واهتم الإسلام أيضا بالمسلم بعد موته فأمر بتغسيله وأمر بتطيبه وحث على تطيبه وأمر بتكفينه وأمر بقبره والصلاة عليه.
And so likewise, even when a Muslim passes away, Islam has come with guidance regarding this stage of life. When a person passes away, how we should wash them, how we should perfume them, how we should shroud them, how we should bury them, how we should pray over them, and so on.
وأمر بعد موته بالدعاء له وحث على الدعاء له وعلى ذكر محاسن الموتى وشرع للأحياء أن يزوروا المقابر الزيارة الشرعية.
And likewise, when a person dies, Islam has allowed for people to make dua for that person and to speak good of the dead, those people that have passed on, to speak good and remember them in a good way. Just as Islam has come and allowed for us to go and visit cemeteries and graveyards in a way that is correct and according to the Islamic Sharia.
إذن فاستفدنا أن الإسلام عني بالمسلم قبل وجوده في هذه الحياة واستمرت العناية به إلى بعد موته.
So therefore we can now understand and appreciate that Islam is a comprehensive religion. It came with guidelines and advice for a Muslim even before he was born and all the way up until after his death.
وأما مرحلة الشباب فهي أخصب مراحل العمر لأن الإنسان في أقوى صحة.
And so as for this stage of life, which is the youth, then there is one of the most difficult stages that a person passes through. Because a person at this time is at the pinnacle of his strength, the peak of his strength.
ولذا كثرت الأحاديث النبوية في السنة عن هذه المرحلة العمرية مرحلة الشباب.
And that's why there are many narrations in the books of Sunnah from our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of them pertaining to the stage of life, the stage of youth.
فمن ذلك قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يا معشر الشباب من استطاع منكم الباءة فليتزوج ومن لم يستطع فعليه بالصوم. يا معشر الشباب من استطاع منكم الباءة فليتزوج فإنه أحصل للفرج وأغض للبصر ومن لم يستطع فعليه بالصوم فإنه له وجاء.
So for example, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in one hadith, O youth, O young people, whosoever from amongst you is able to marry, then he should do so, for that is more modest for him, and it will help him to lower his gaze. And whosoever is unable to do so, then they should fast.
فالشاب قوي الشهوة وأقوى مراحل شهوة الإنسان في حال شبابه. ولذا حث الإسلام على الزواج حتى لا تفرغ هذه الشهوة في أمر الحرام. فإذا ما استطاع الزواج فهناك الصيام. وأنتم في هذا البلد وفي مثله معرضون للنساء في كل حين بكامل زينتهن، والإنسان يضعف، فالنساء ذهابا وإيابا، ففي حقكم الزواج على من كان قادرا واجب إذا خشي على نفسه الفتنة. لأن الإنسان إذا رأى المرأة يضعف ويتعلق بها.
The Shaykh said that a person as a youth, this is normally the time when their desires are the strongest, when they are the most vicious at this time of youth. And that's why Islam has come and has recommended that people at this age, in this time of life, they should marry. And this is something which Islam has recommended so that people don't go and fall into haram, especially in the stage of youth. And if they're unable to marry for whatever reason, then they should fast. And the Shaykh continued and he said, especially in a country like this where you live, where there are many, many types of trials, many, many types of things which will increase your desire. When you go out and all you see is women. When you come in, all you see is women. Everywhere around you, there are women. And so this increases your desire. And so therefore, in a country like this, for those people who are able to, it is obligatory upon them to get married if they fear for themselves that they will fall into some type of fitna because of the excess amount that they see of things which are haram.
وقد يكون بعضنا غير قادر على الزواج فليجاهد نفسه أولا عليه بدعاء الله تعالى أن ييسر أمره، وثانيا عليه بمجاهدة نفسه في البعد عما يثير شهوته من شيء من منظر من ما يرى أو يسمع، وثالثا عليه أن يستعين بعد عون الله بالصوم، ورابعا أن يسعى في مادة أو في جمع مال زواجه وسيعينه الله، لأن الله يقول إن يكونوا فقراء يغنيهم الله من فضله.
So the Shaykh said, and it may well be possible that there are people who are unable to get married for whatever reason. So what should these people do? He said, number one, they should make dua to Allah. Ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make their affairs easy for them. Number two, they should struggle with themselves. They should place effort into struggling with themselves so that they stay away from things which will increase their desires, things which will be a source of trial for them. Number three, after seeking the assistance of Allah, then they should fast. And number four, they should take those means by which they can get married. So if they need wealth, they should start to join and gather this wealth so that they can get married. And Allah Azza wa Jal will help and assist them, as He says in the Quran, if they are poor, then Allah will enrich them from His bounty.
ومن عناية الإسلام بالشباب قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. وذكر في أول الحديث شاب نشأ في أو ذكر شابا نشأ في طاعة الله، فهذا دليل على أن الإنسان إذا حفظ شبابه وأقام شبابه وسخر عمره في طاعة الله من أول شبابه فإن ذلك دليل إن شاء الله على استمراره على طاعة الله وعلى توفيق الله له.
Likewise, from that which shows how Islam came and gave guidelines for youth is the famous hadith of our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, in which he said, seven people Allah Azza wa Jal will shade them on Yawm al-Qiyamah, on the day that there is no shade except His shade subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he mentioned towards the beginning of this hadith a young person who is nurtured in the obedience and the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this shows that this person, or a person who during their youth they preserve the obedience of Allah and they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they're steadfast upon this, then inshallah this is a sign that they will continue upon this path as they grow older, and it is a sign inshallah that Allah wants good for them.
حتى ولو أن الإنسان تاب إلى الله وهو كبير فهو على خير ومن خير وإلى خير. فبعض الناس قد يأتيه الشيطان فيقول أنت كبرت وتقدمت في السن فلا تنفعك الطاعة ولا التوبة، هذا من تلبيس إبليس. بل على الإنسان أن يتوب من أول ما يذنب وأن يتجنب الذنوب، فإذا وفقه الله إلى التوبة فعليه بحمد أن يحمد الله وأن
الشيخ said that it may be possible that some people are old in age, they are no longer in the stage of youth, and they may have had a youth in which they committed sin. Even these people should return to Allah and they should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there is a lot of goodness in this. Sometimes shaitan will come to a person and he will whisper to them that you're old now, you spent so many years sinning and disobeying Allah, there's no benefit in returning to Allah now, there's no benefit in repenting to Allah now. And the Shaykh said this is from the traps of shaitan and from the deceptions of shaitan. But rather a person, as soon as they sin and they disobey Allah, they should return to him and they should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once they have stopped sinning and they have returned to obedience, then they should be grateful and thank Allah Azza wa Jal and praise him.
وأيضا من عناية الإسلام بمرحلة الشباب قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يأتيكم شباب من أقطار الأرض يتفقهون في دين الله فإذا رأيتموهم فاستوصوا بهم خيرا فإنهم وصية رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Also that which shows how in this religion has paid extra care and attention to the stage of youth is the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, in which he said, there will come to you a group of young people from different parts of the world, and they will come so that they can learn and understand their religion. So if they come, then do good to them and be good towards them, for indeed these are the people who are the will of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فكلما كان الشاب عنده علم كلما كان أكثر نفعا لأهل بيته ولوالديه ولعشيرته ولمن يجالس.
So the more that a young person, a youth, the more knowledge that they have, the more beneficial they will be for themselves and for their families and for their parents and for those people that interact with them and sit with them.
وتحصير الشاب للعلم أقوى وأيسر من تحصيل غيره له من كبار السن. فالشاب فيه قوة بدنية وقوة ذهنية وهو أكثر استجماعاً لتحصيل العلم من غيره، فعليه أن يستغل هذا العمر في تحصيل العلم.
And the Shaykh said that it is possible, or it is more likely, that a person during their young age, as a youth, that they will seek knowledge in a better way. And it will be much easier for them than someone else who is much older than them in age. And that's why we find that when there is someone who is young in age, a youth, they have more strength in their body. They have more strength in their mind and in their intellect. And they're more able and more apt to gather the different sciences of Islam and learn about their religion. And so therefore they should use and benefit from this time that they have.
وليس المراد أن كل أحد يطلب العلم ويقرأ، ولكن حضورك في مجالس العلم وسماعك للعلم وسؤالك عن الخير هذا كله إن شاء الله من طلب العلم.
And what is not meant here by the Sheikh isn't that everyone goes and just becomes a dedicated student of knowledge, but rather the fact that a person comes and he attends lectures like these, or he reads, or he listens, or he asks questions. This is a sign of a student of knowledge as well.
أخيرا الشاب أكثر أو استقامة الشاب وصلاحه أكثر تأثيرا من غيره. فالشاب يجالس جميع طبقات المجتمع، يجالس الصغار، ويجالس من كان في سنه، ويجالس الكبار. فإذا كان الشاب على خلق وعلى أدب وعلى علم نفعه الله ونفع به من سمعه وجالسه أو رأه.
And the Sheikh said also finally that when it comes to the youth, if they are people who are possessing good character, people of knowledge, people who are steadfast and upright, then their impact and the effects that they have will be far greater than anyone else. Why? Because the youth are people who integrate and they mix with all different types of people. They sit with the young, they sit with people in their own age group, they sit with the elders. And so if this young person has good character and they have knowledge of the religion, then they will benefit themselves and they will benefit others by the will of Allah from those that they see and those that they talk to and those that they sit with.
ختاما الله أسأل أن يوفق مجتمعات المسلمين وأن يجمع شملهم على الخير وأن يؤلف بين قلوبهم وأبدانهم إنه تعالى سميع مجيب. كما أسأل الله أن يوفقكم جميعاً وأن يجعلكم قدوة لمن جالسكم ولمن صاحبكم ولمن سمع عنكم ورآكم. شكر الله لكم والحمد لله الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات وصلى الله وسلم على رسول الله.
Finally, the Sheikh ended and concluded by making dua for everyone, and he made dua that Allah Azza wa Jal makes the societies and the communities of the Muslims blessed, and that Allah Azza wa Jal guides them to that which is good, and that He blesses them. And he made dua for you as well, that Allah Azza wa Jal grants you success in this life and the next. And so inshallah with that, we're going to conclude this short lecture, and inshallah we'll take a 10-minute break.
غربا غربا غربا